And hello everyone, the penultimate day of the World Championship has come to an end. I have already lost count of what day it is today, but today was the most important for the individual gymnasts because today they competed for the most important medal, as it often called the Olympic medal, since this is the only discipline in which medal at the Olympics is awarded. Well, before you find out how the all round ended, I suggest discussing some interesting facts related to this tournament. So, it was the first final of the individual all round competition in which 18 gymnasts performed. This was the third such final for Barbara Dominguez, as well as Elizaveta Plastinaia from Latvia, Sofia Rafaeli from Italy, Margarita Kolosa from Germany, Andrea Verdes from Romania, and Tatiana Voloshinina from Bulgaria. Well, one more interesting fact, but probably not about this tournament, but more about judging in general. While we were watching the World Championship, news came out that FIG had returned Natalia Kuzmina, the chairman of the technical committee, as a candidate of the election of new head of technical committee. Later, the vice president of the International Gymnastic Federation commented on this point and said that it was probably a temporary measure, and proceedings on these issues are now underway through the Ethical Foundation. So, I've also thought a lot about refereeing. So, what I think about it? Now, there is a huge number of video analysis exercises, and in general, all the performances from each tournament can be easily found on the internet. But the most curious thing is that there used to be a lot of debriefing, although there were not so many of them. And these debriefings very often show that Russia is rated higher than it really is, and perhaps now they have begun to judge really honestly. And therefore, it seems to us that our gymnasts are being sued, because we didn't attach importance to such reviews before, and Russia didn't say anything in the news. And myself, I didn't pay attention to these reviews before, so I thought they were made by envious people of Russia. And now, you can find any analysis of the exercises with any outcome, and how one won and how the other won. So, it's possible that the technical committee is now judging more strictly and according to the rules with an open access to the exercises, so anyone can see any exercises and sue it and then post it online. Either the technical committee had problems with such analysis and they have now revised their approach to work. In general, this is what I think about it. Well, now let's get to the results of the all-round. The gold medal was won by Dina Averina, a gymnast of Russia. So, for Dina, it was a record. In total, she won 18 world championships. Gold medals, and it is the fourth victory in the all-round. Dina became the only gymnast in the world who managed to win the medals of absolute championship 4 times in a row. Previously, she was equal with Ayana Kudryavtseva and Evgenia Kanaeva, who were absolute championships 3 times. Dina also became one of 2 gymnasts who participated in the all-round finals during the Olympic cycle. The second was Milena Baldassari from Italy. Arina Averina missed the world championship in 2008, where Alexandra Soldatova got into the all-round. Wonderful victory and wonderful performance Dina demonstrated today throughout all apparatus. It wasn't perfect for exercises, but today, and as always, no one did everything perfectly. Well, there were also a nice moment at the award ceremony when Dina took her sister by the hand and they listened to Tchaikovsky together holding hands. It is cool when your family is with you even on the pedestal. The silver medal was won by Alina Harnaska, a gymnast of Belarus. She became the first gymnast since 1999 to win silver in the all-round. During this period, only Milutina Staniuta managed to climb to the podium of the World Championship for bronze. Alina also made mistakes today, so in the ribbon she almost went over the carpet, and there were other minor mistakes, and the gap from the first place for Alina was 3 points. Arina Averina, another Russian gymnast, won the bronze medal. This was her third participation in the all-round World Championship, and her first bronze. Before that, Arina won silver medals in the all-round in 2017 and 2019. Arina unfortunately made more serious mistakes today, including a loss which didn't allow her to fight for silver and gold. And also there were quite a lot of errors in the hoop, for which she was deducted quite decently. But by the way, many have already begun to write that we were sued again. But I hasten to reassure you that Irina Alexandrovna Viner said in the interview that everything is fine and she doesn't mind that Arina was deducted. So everyone is calm and didn't swear. In general, after the final, Irina Viner said that the judging was normal both today and yesterday. While returning to Arina, I especially like her confidence and dedication today, despite all of the mistakes. About the completion of the career of Averins sisters, Irina Viner commented that she didn't know yet how it would turn out and said that for today we need to just be happy. The fourth place was taken by Bulgarian gymnast Brianna Kalain. For Brianna, this world championship remained near podium with no medals and mostly fourth places. But Brianna didn't do her programs cleanly, so the result is obvious. The fifth place was Victoria Nabrienko, which was a very good result for Victoria, and I think this is a real success for the Ukrainian national team. Sofia Rafaela took the sixth place, confidently doing all of her programs, with the exception to the clubs. There were a small error that could be counted as a loss. I don't think Sofia fought for medals at this championship, given that it was her first tournament of this level. But she clearly declared herself and will make us nervous for the next season. I think Sofia deserves to be called the best debut of the World Championship. Tatiana Volozhenina became the seventh. She also coped well with her own programs in the all-round final. Tatiana has taken a leadership position in the Bulgarian national team, and I'm sure that we can still talk about her growth. Japanese gymnast Kita Sumire became the eighth. For her and her coach, this championship has clearly become a successful start. Good results, and Kita is not quite an age gymnast yet, so I'm sure that we will see her in the next season. The ninth place was taken by another Italian gymnast, Milena Baldassari, and this championship she lost to her teammate, but in any case, this is not a bad result. In 2017, she was ninth in the all-round, 7th in 2018 and 2019, and 9th again in 2021. There is not stability whatsoever. Well, the top 10 leaders were closed by Belarusian gymnast Anastasia Salas. She started performing well with her programs, but in the hoop, again, it wasn't possible to do the program cleanly. Another insulting loss with going off of the carpet. In any case, Anastasia is the favorite of the public, and we can only wish a stronger nerves for her so as not to make mistakes and already fight for medals of such tournaments. In addition to the all-round, a prize for style was awarded. This year, Japanese gymnast Kita Sumire received it. And write in the comments which of the 10 leaders you remember and like the most. You can even make your own personal top. It will be interesting to equalize your favorites. And do you think the Averina sisters will finish their career or they will stay for a new season and try themselves in the new roles? Well, tomorrow we are waiting for the last day of the World Championship. Gymnasts will compete for their individual medals in the group exercises. The competition will begin at 11:30 Moscow time. I think you already know where to find detailed information, so remember that I love you all very much and bye bye!